Welcome to installment number 231 of the Mitzvahs as enumerated by Maimonides, the Rambam. Today we are talking about the impurity of vessels. Now, what's interesting is that there isn't actually a particular verse or a particular mitzvah that discusses the impurity of vessels. Maimonides tells us that whatever can impurify a person, can impurify a human being, can impurify a vessel. So today, Positive Commandment 108 basically discusses, we are actually talking about the impurity of the Maimonides, the waters of a red heifer that can impurify a vessel. So basically what Maimonides is doing is he's going back, and being that, as we said, there is not a specific mitzvah, he goes back and repeats all the 13 impurities that we've been talking about. And as we said, if they can impurify a human, any human being who is impurified in such a manner and touches a vessel renders the vessel impure. So there are 13 impurities that we've discussed. Let's see if I remember them all. We have the impurity of a carcass, a dead animal that was not slaughtered properly. We have the impurity of those eight animals that we've discussed. We have the impurity of a nida, a woman who menstruates, a woman who gives birth. We have the impurity of the zav and a zava, the man or the woman that has a strange emission at an abnormal time. We have the impurity of the emission of semen. We have the impurity of food we've been speaking about. We have the impurity of three different types of impurity of tzara'as. Tzara'as on a human body, tzara'as on a garment, tzara'as on a home. Tzara'as, as we said, is commonly translated as leprosy, but is not exactly that. It is more of a biblical illness. We have the impurity of a dead body, and we have the impurity of the red heifer. Now, what is interesting about this impurity is that once a red heifer was found, it was slaughtered properly in the manner it needed to be slaughtered. And then, you know, we've discussed the whole system, the whole process of this got mixed with spring water, and then this mixture was then sprinkled on the person who was impure with the impurity of a dead person, and thus rendered pure. However, what is interesting about this is that it really depended on the intention. That if the intention was that it was going to purify an impure person, then that's what it did. However, if a person was already pure, then they became impure from this sprinkling. So it really mattered on what the intention was and what was planned in advance. So for the next few days, we are going to be discussing the different manners in which a vessel can be rendered impure. Today was day one. Have a wonderful day.